Do you want to know what are the five essential business skills for healthcare businessmen? Hi, this is Nitin and welcome to another episode of Enlightened Healthpreneur podcast with Nitin. And today we will be talking about what are the top business skills to learn for doctors. Yes, doctors are very much educated people in their domain knowledge, but they don't have the business skill which is required to run their clinic or dispensary or hospital in an efficient and profitable manner. So if you want to learn what are the skills, business skills that doctors should learn, so you can continue with me on this podcast. So let's get started with this. And before that, if you are new to this channel, to this podcast, please subscribe to my channel. And we'll be starting with today's podcast about five essential business skills for healthcare businessmen. And we need to understand why a doctor should learn this business skills. Because as I mentioned, it's a critical business skills for their success. If they don't have this skill, they can definitely become a good doctors, but they cannot run their hospital or clinic in a profitable manner. So the very first skill that they need to have as a doctor is to understand the economics. You don't need to learn the detailed concepts, or you don't need to have a degree or curriculum in economics, but you need to have a basic understanding of economics, particularly business economics, because it's one of the key business skill. And if required, you can take some crash course, because if you don't have understanding of how to run a business, and if you don't understand the economics of the profitability and running the business, then you are running towards the poverty mindset. Your business might be earning, but that will not be a sustainable or profitable business. That's why I'm calling it a poverty mindset. Then the next skill that you should have is the negotiation skills. It is one of the best business skills that any healthcare businessman should have. If you don't know how to negotiate with your staff, your employees, or maybe even your patients, you will not be able to efficiently deliver what needs to be done. For example, if you don't know how to negotiate with your employees, you will not be able to get the work done in an efficient manner. If you don't know how to negotiate with a patient, patient might lose on his health. I am not asking you to negotiate on the monetary part with the patient, but most of the times when patient negotiate for their health, doctor, can I take some alternative treatment? Doctor, can I avoid this surgery? But as a doctor, you know that that particular treatment is very essential for the patient's better health. And patient might not understand that. He might not understand the criticality of that treatment. Patient is looking at only his comfort. But as a doctor, you need to make patient understand why that particular treatment is essential for his health improvement. And that's why you need to have those negotiation skills. You need to learn what are the negotiation strategies and what are the negotiation tactics that you can use in different situations. Then the next important skill that a doctor must have is the leadership skill. Why leadership skill? It's because one of the important business skill that a doctor can have. You need to understand how to be a leader. You can go for some kind of leadership training. So leadership means that people are following you. It doesn't mean that you give instruction to people and they follow your orders. No, leadership means when you talk with the people, people get influenced by just your words, and they are inspired. They are either touched, moved by your qualities and your thoughts. So that's why you need to have those leadership skills. If you want to learn those leadership qualities, and if you want me to make the next podcast on what are the qualities of a leader, kindly like my video. If my video gets maximum number of likes and shares, I will make a podcast on qualities of a leader. Okay. Then the next essential skill that a doctor can have is the effective communication. You need to have that skill, how to improve your communication skill, because when you understand how you can improve your communication skill, you can efficiently and effectively communicate at your workplace. And when you are able to provide your message to the next person, there is no confusion in your work, particularly in case of medical practice. The communication is very essential to deliver the right message. If there is slightly miscommunication, it can result in disastrous results, which can be very critical for your clinical practice. If you want to learn how you can improve your communication skills and how you can effectively communicate within your workplace with your employees and your staff, you can join the community called Healthcare Business Forum, and where I teach doctors how they can improve on their communication and can be more productive in their day-to-day practice. If you want to join that community, please click on the link given in the description box and you can become a member of the community along with other doctors. Then the next essential skill is having the decision-making skill. If you have that decision-making skill, it's a lifesaver, because in medical practice, decision-making can, a few movements can make a life and death situation for any patient. It's not about just your business, it's about your clinical practice also. So you need to practice to develop this decision-making skills. To have that, you need to have a mindset of successful healthcare businessman. And what does it mean by having a mindset of successful businessman? It includes the having a psychology of decision, understanding the decision-making process. You need to understand how to make better decisions and not get influenced or carried emotionally by certain situations. You need to be firm even in very stressful situation. That's why it will help you to survive not your just business, but it will also help you positively in your clinical practice. So if you like this podcast, kindly like and share with your friends. And if you are new to this channel, you can subscribe so that when the next podcast is released, it will reach to your inbox. So thank you. Bye for the day.